So, update on the 100 watt light. Got it all hooked up. Two batteries in series and out parallel. Turn it on. So it's about 2.3 amps, which according to math is about 79 watts. My goal is 80, but hey, I'll take 79. Sucker is bright. Oh yeah, this, it's a dimmer. Let's run 2.3 watts, or amps. Now it's running much lower, much less current draw, and easier on the eyes. All right, now I'm gonna test the current draw. Got my fluke hooked up. Trying to do this with one hand. All right. So just the fan going and the booster turning on, the DC-DC converter. 169 milliamps. 168. So LED on. That's on low. I'm drawing about 1.6 amps. So not too bad. And then with it on high, 7.3 amps, 7.4. That's a lot, and this thing's kind of bright. I'm trying to shield my eyes. 7.5. Okay. Just running some numbers. This thing's ridiculous. Alright, I finished it. It's a 100 watt cool white LED. Collector, fixture, no lens because I don't feel like putting one on there. So, it's a cigar box with a bunch of cosmetic surgery done to it. It's a bunch of witchcraft going on in here. Some electrons being pushed, pulled, and squeezed, and shoved, and maybe some other stuff, I don't know. But I'm powered by two nickel metal hydride batteries, 3300 milliamp hour, running in series. Actual voltage, it's like 16 volts instead of 14.4. Bunch of switches here. You got a 100 watt DC-DC converter, voltage booster, also constant current. So I regulate the current for the LED. And then I have two 20 ohm 100 watt resistors in there. That's for the high and low switch. They're wired in parallel. 12 volt cooling fan, heat sink, air comes in here, comes in this way, blows over the resistors, which actually aren't going to get hot, and they're actually in contact with the heat sink. And then the air blows through the heat sink on the voltage booster right there, comes out these slots right there, pretty nifty. Got two LEDs on the back, I soldered on the back of the board. If you look at my watch my part one video, I think I talked about that. There's these three pins right here. I desoldered that middle LED and I put two on the back instead. I thought it was cooler. So when I turn this on, that happens, and then when it's under load, the green one comes on as seen. Okay, I got these buttons going on here. I need to explain. This is the on, no button. Pretty self-explanatory. And see, this is the sometimes button where I push it and it stays on kind of sometimes. This is the more button. You push it and you get more light. Well, it stays on more time. Now this is the new feature I don't have on my other light. This is a new one on this one. It has the VTEC 1.6 amp setting because it draws 1.6 amps from the batteries. And then the power setting. Imagine Jeremy Clarkson saying that. Where it's drawing 7.3 amps. That's the full 79 watts. This one, I haven't calculated it, but you can take a guess at what it's doing. So there's the economical VTEC. And then there's the full power setting. Now I will make a part 3 video of actually using this outside. So stay tuned for that. I'm glad this thing's done. Well, almost done. I'm gonna cut this out even bigger, put a wire mesh screen over it or something. This thing sucks bugs into it, chops them up, and it's a insect graveyard in here. Well, it's pretty ugly, so I'll fix that. And I'll probably make a latch or something for this to keep the lid down, but until then, hey, it works. I'm happy. All my switches work. There they are. Hope you enjoy the video. Well, it's the end of the video, so you know what to do now.